Namaste, welcome to the session Stability Analysis and Hurwitz Criteria. At the end of this session, students will be able to apply Hurwitz criteria and analyze the stability of system. In this session, we are going to see Hurwitz criteria and how to analyze stability of a system using Hurwitz criteria. The transfer function of any linear closed loop system represented by y of s divided by x of s equal to b0 s raised to m plus b1 s raised to m minus 1 plus so on bm minus 1 s plus bm divided by a0 s raised to n plus a1 s raised to n minus 1 plus an minus 1 s plus an, where b and a are constants here. Roots of denominator polynomial of a transfer function are called poles, whereas roots of numerator polynomials of a transfer function are called zeros. To find out closed loop poles, the denominator equation of transfer function, which is also called as characteristics equation of a system, should be equated to zero. So here the denominator from the above transfer function is equated to zero. So roots of the characteristics equation are the closed loop poles of the system, which decide the stability of the system. Now take a pause here and recall how poles of the system on S plane decide the stability of the system. So I think you have recalled from the last session, when poles are on the left side of the S plane, then it is a stable system. When poles are on the right hand side of the S plane, then system is unstable. When poles are there on the imaginary axis without repeating the poles, then system is marginally stable or critically stable system. And there are other conditions. There are two necessary but insufficient conditions for the roots of the characteristics equation to lie in left hand side of S plane for the system to be stable. The conditions are, first condition is all the coefficients of polynomial should have the same sign, and second condition is all coefficients of the polynomial should present in the equation, that is none of the coefficients vanish. But these two conditions are not sufficient to find out a system is stable or not. Now according to these two conditions, find out whether given system is stable or not by observing this equation. So after observing this equation and remembering the previous condition, you can say that system is not stable, because here we have negative value, all the coefficients are not positive, so one of the coefficient is negative, so system does not satisfy the necessary condition for stability. Now let us have one more example. So for given equation, is the system stable? You can observe that all the powers of S are there, but S raised to 2 is not there. So S square is absent, so system does not satisfy the necessary condition for stability. So a system is unstable if all signs of coefficient of the denominator of the closed loop transfer function are not same, and if powers of S are missing from the denominator of the closed loop transfer function, then the system is either unstable or sometimes it may be marginally stable. But what if all coefficients are positive and no power of S is missing? Then how to find out whether system is stable or not? So for that we have Hurwitz criteria. So what is Hurwitz criteria? Adolf Hurwitz was a German mathematician who worked on algebra, analysis, geometry, and number theory. In the field of control system and dynamical system theory, Hurwitz derived the stability criteria for determining whether a system is stable in 1895. So let us see Hurwitz criteria. Hurwitz criteria states that the necessary and sufficient condition to have all the roots of the characteristics equation in left half of S plane is that the subdeterminants dk, where k may be 1, 2, 3 up to n, obtained from Hurwitz determinant H must be positive. So all the determinants in Hurwitz criteria must be positive. So for this characteristics equation, how to write Hurwitz table? So Hurwitz table is given as dk, which is also nothing but Hurwitz table, H is equal to, now here first row is written from the coefficients of the equation. So first row here is having all the odd coefficients a1, a3, a5, a7 and so on. Then second row of the Hurwitz table is written from all the even coefficients a0, a2, a4, a6 and so on. The third row of Hurwitz table is written by including 0 first and then copying first row as it is. Then next row is written by entering 0 first and copying the second row as it is. And third row, the next row is written as including 0 and copying the third row and so on. So this is how we can write Hurwitz table from the characteristics equation of a system. Now how to find out different determinants of Hurwitz criteria? So here D1 is 1 by 1 matrix of Hurwitz table. So here you can see D1 is equal to A1. Then how to write D2? Determinant 2, it is nothing but 2 by 2 matrix A1, A3, A0, A2. Then third determinant of Hurwitz is written as D3 is equal to 3 by 3 matrix. Then fourth determinant of Hurwitz criteria is written as 4 by 4 matrix from the Hurwitz table. Now let us see stability analysis using Hurwitz criteria. So for example, find out the stability of the system for given equation. The equation given is s cube plus 8s square plus 14s plus 24. So let us find out the coefficients of equation. So here you can find out a0 is 1, a1 is 8, a2 is 14, a3 is 24. Now we know that Hurwitz criteria and Hurwitz table, where first row is including all the odd coefficients from the characteristics equation, second row including all the even coefficients of characteristics equation, then third row is written by including 0 first and copying the first row as it is, then next row is written as including 0 first and copying the second row and so on. So let us write Hurwitz table for the given equation. So you can see here Hurwitz table for given equation. So first row should be all the odd coefficient of the equation. So a1 here is 8, then a3 is 24, there is no a5, so it is 0. Then second row includes all the even coefficients, where a0 is 1, a2 is 14, as there is no a4, so here it is 0. Then to write the third row from this equation, we have to include 0 here, then first row as it is we have to copy. So in the first row we have 8, 24 and 0, but here we are including 8 and 24 because there are no further coefficient to make the Hurwitz-stable 4x4 matrix. So from this equation we have Hurwitz-stable which is of 3x3. So from this Hurwitz table for the given equation, D1 is 1x1 matrix where D1 is equal to 8, then D2 is 2x2 matrix where the coefficients are 8, 24, 1, 14, and D3 is the whole table as it is, which is 3x3 matrix. So after calculating D1, D2, D3, we have here 8, which is positive, D2 88, which is also positive, D3 2112, which is also positive. So what we can conclude is, as all the determinants of Hurwitz are positive, so this system is stable. So if one of the determinant is negative, then system could have been unstable. So in this way we can analyze characteristics equation of a system and find out whether it is stable or unstable from Hurwitz criteria. These are references. Thank you.